right to the racks. Then I make that shit back. Run up on me, get shot in the back.
JT in the building. If you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, man, we better make it. Today we got the Warner Bronx OG versus YG versus SevSide. Dropped on Hip Hop Daily, man. Mm. You gotta cover the Bronx because the Bronx is lit, right?
The Bronx.
How do you feel the Bronx?
Bronx, New York.
Right.
Tell you a little story about the Bronx.
Uh-huh.
This is where hip hop started.
Yes, sir.
If it wasn't for the Bronx, none of this would be going on.
What's up, fuck?
How I feel about the Bronx? I'm from the Bronx, born and bred. So I'm for the Bronx.
That's a fact.
I'm on Bronx all day.
K flocking up.
We hood in the Bronx. We got pools in the corners. We got whatever, man. We got the outdoor pools and the street corners. We got the fire hydrants. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But let's hop right to it. Can you try to subscribe, request, and react? I don't know what he was talking about right there. He had lost a thought. What is it?
I'm 67. Sometimes my mind wanders. But look, check it out on UK.
Top seven.
People, somebody said today was that we gotta put
New York Jones.
We gotta take Tion Wayne and put Jay Huss in there.
Okay.
So who do we take out? Put Jay Huss.
And you guys want a New York top seven?
Nah, we're not doing New York. Don't even front. We're not doing that shit.
All right, bro. Like the video if you have yet. Let's get right to it.
UK all day, y'all.
What are you saying on this video? The Warner Bronx OGs versus YGs versus SevSide.
Let's go.
Bronx.
The Bronx is a wild place. It's the borough with the most crime and is well known for gang activity. The Bronx drill sound is on the rise and is fueling the deadly war between three gangs. The OGs, the YGs, and SevSide.
All right, it's funny because if Hip Hop Daily covers you, you know you're lit. Because Hip Hop Daily has some good content. He'd be saying facts. Come on, we cover some
stuff. He got a smooth cadence. So the Bronx is a deadly place.
We did the UK drill night fights. We did the Young Days one.
We covered that before.
Yeah. War between three gangs. The OGs, the YGs, and SevSide. Let's get straight into this crazy beat. Brooklyn was getting attention for his drill scene, but K-Flop. The Bronx is coming with a whole new sound that's starting to make waves. K-Flop is one of the hottest rappers from the Bronx right now,
Racking
up millions of plays on songs like Being Honest and PSA. Bronx drill may have the same bass lines and hard flow as Brooklyn and UK drill, but it has its own unique sound that's influenced by classic New York hip hop. Most of the beats, that's classic samples
like that give me chills when you say that because they are like, it's like these kids, and I think you can only do it if you're in that environment.
Yeah,
they grow up with the very pureness of hip hop.
Word.
So they're recycling it and making their own version of it.
It's a fact.
So they're not like a lot of music genres and TV, they throw away the old stuff and try to invent something new.
Yeah, they're not really.
These kids, they take some of the old stuff. But they sprinkle, they join in. It is something new, but the sprinkle of the old.
That's a fact.
Sound that's influenced by classic New York hip hop. Most of the beats have classic samples laced in with distorted 808s that gives the music a different vibe than drill from the area.
You guys don't know what an 808 is. Please stop and subscribe real quick because we drop gems in this channel.
Word.
The 808 is a drum beat machine, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's one of the originals. DJ D Nice had a song talking about the 808. You know what I'm saying? The 808 is influential in the hip hop scene. I believe it was made in Japan initially.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? For music. And we turned around and used it as a hip hop.
For beats.
Tool.
Yes, sir.
With distorted 808, that gives the music a different vibe than drill from other areas. K-Flock has been riding the wave with his new sound and has been building a buzz over the past few months. But his come up ain't just been all success. He also suffers from the pain and loss that comes with the street life, losing many friends to gun violence. K-Flock hopped off the curb at a young age and was on the block at like 12 years old. He started rapping because of his homie Dougie B, who's also a rapper and has been featured on multiple tracks. K-Flock's first official track was a remix of the 22G song, Licky Gang Freestyle, which he titled FTO.
Damn, that's his first shot.
22G's then gave K-Flock a shout out in a recent interview showing love to the Bronx drill movement. In August 2021, he remixed Siggy Black's song, Dishonest, and called it Being Honest.
Yeah.
That track quickly racked up millions of views.
Dishonest though.
Siggy Black was the first one.
Never heard of it.
Yeah, he's from Brooklyn, but everybody started remixing that song. It was fire.
Called it Being Honest.
Yeah. Dishonest.
I didn't know that. See, that's good. You got the roots in culture. You gotta know where it comes from.
That's fine.
Dishonest and called it Being Honest. That track quickly racked up millions of views and earned him a feature from G Herbo. There's also rumors that he recently signed a 7-figure deal and he's in a good position to take over the Bronx rap scene. But behind all of K-Flock's success is a deadly war that involves his own family members. He's from a blood set around East 187th Street in a hood known as SevSide. SevSide is made up of Mac Baller Brims and Sex Money Murder, and they cool with the Rolling 80s Crips. SevSide beats with other gangs in the area, including the OGs, or Original Goons, and the YGs, or Young Gunners. At first, these two was the same gang and controlled a few different projects around Cortland Ave, not far from SevSide. But one of the founders of the YGs crossed over another top member.
Cortland Ave is far from, if you're saying SevSide, it's 27th. Yeah, Cortland Ave is very far from it, actually. It's like 30 blocks.
Yeah, that's
the Bronx is a big borough.
Right.
But it's interesting that he said that they were all one gang.
Yeah.
We were getting that too when we covered some of the UK.
There was one gang.
There was one gang and then in like London. Beef. And then they beefed.
Inter beef.
They had internal beef and then they split and made their own branches. But I guess that happens in gang culture.
Yeah,
I would say.
That happens. Crip beef with Crips nowadays.
Yeah. So it's,
not far from SevSide, but one of the founders of the YGs crossed over another top member, so the dudes in his hood split off to form the OGs. Today, the YGs are one of the most hated gangs in the Bronx, and they beef with almost everyone. One of the YGs' main rappers, named Dthang, is K-Flock's blood cousin. The two rappers have been dissing each other back and forth.
Dthang
shot the whole hood by dropping
the track. How did cousins diss each other?
And I like both their music. Hopefully nothing escalates out of it. Maybe they can make some money out of, you know, the whole energy of, like, hip-hop not beefing, but competitiveness.
That's a fact.
I mean, it doesn't have to turn violent.
See, they're RPT in the back of any business.
Yeah, yeah, and they took it earlier. They were at the courthouse jumping around. That's 161. That's my blood.
Yeah.
The two rappers have been dissing each other back and forth. Dthang shocked the whole hood by dropping a Chicago-style drill track called Talking Facts, where he disrespects dead ops from damn near every gang the YG's beef with. But the beef ain't start with rap.
Go check
out
reactions to that song, actually.
Yeah,
did that.
No cap. Good turnout, too. A lot of people put eyeballs on it.
From damn near every gang, the YG's beef
word.
But the beef ain't start with rap.
Damn.
It began with multiple murders, followed by threats in music and on social media. Mm. In July 2021, a 19-year-old rapper who went by the name Ty Swish was shot in the head in the lobby of his apartment building.
Damn.
He ran outside after getting shot, but had been hit in the eye and quickly collapsed. A family friend and her two kids found him unconscious outside the building. He was rushed to the hospital, but he was dead at the scene. Witnesses say the gunman fled in a dark-colored four-door sedan, but was never identified. Friends and neighbors said Ty Swish was a good kid who never got in trouble, but he was allegedly from sex money murder, and they would quickly even the score for his death. A few days later, 13-year-old Jerry and Elliot was chased down and killed outside the Angels Cafe on neighborhood of the Bronx. Jerry had just graduated from junior high and was turning 14 later that month. But even though he was young, he already claimed to be from the rolling 80s Crips. He
had already got the rolling 80s. It's kind of interesting because I know the rolling 60s are very popular in Brooklyn.
Oh, really?
That comes from Cali. You know what I mean? Everything originates from California.
Yeah, yeah.
And they spread out. That's crazy.
Wow.
I don't know. I never heard about the rolling 80s though.
But even though he was young, he already claimed to be from the rolling 80s Crips. He had already got arrested 8 times for robbery and assault and spent time in juvie.
Wow.
A friend of Jerrion's said the Crips put him on when he was 10 years old and that she tried to warn him about the lifestyle.
10 years old?
The murder was captured on surveillance footage and showed Jerrion walking down the street with a friend. A black sedan is seen driving up alongside him, then coming to a stop. A mass shooter then hops out and shoots at both of them. His friend ran away, but Jerrion falls and then crawls into a local cafe. He got shot in the legs and the chest and was rushed to the hospital, but later pronounced dead. Police think Jerrion's death was payback for killing Ty Swish. They don't know if he was the killer, but they believe he was there at the time of the murder.
Just wow, that's crazy. 13 years old.
Wow, that's sad. That's
crazy.
13, yeah. A baby.
Broad daylight too.
Yeah.
Swish. They don't know if he was the killer, but they believe he was there at the time of the murder. Just a few hours after Jerrion got chipped, the ops got their revenge and a 16-year-old got killed, and police think it was a payback hit. On Sunday, July 11th, a 16-year-old rapper named Rod G's was shot while getting into an Uber. Rod G's was from the 800 YG's, and the shooting is believed to be retaliation for the murder of Jerry and Elliot.
Mm.
Rod G's supposedly made fun of Jerry's death on social media right after it happened, and the get back was immediate. He was on his way to the studio, and two men on scooters pulled up and started dumping shots into his Uber. The whole thing was captured on the driver's dash cam and quickly went viral on social media. The rapper got shot once before, but survived. His mom said he was trying to turn his life around and was focusing on his music career. But he didn't get that chance and instead became another casualty in this deadly war.
Damn.
But the case...
These kids are not even...
Wow, it's like, the crazy part is like the beef ain't even... like.
This is over rap too, I feel like. Like, you know how rap... I feel like a lot of rap escalates to beef. Like, people are already beefing, but... when you diss niggas in tracks,
it escalates. And also, like I tell people, the culture, you know, the culture that we, the older G's are guilty of,
right.
Like we were into hip hop and we loved the music, and everything, and people reported what's going on.
Yeah.
But the next generation grew up, they rapping and they living that life.
Word.
You know what I mean? A lot of the older G's that are living that life wasn't rapping, they was living that life.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But now these kids really like
rapping and doing it.
Rapping and doing it. You know what I'm saying? So it's all like one big firebomb. You know what I'm saying?
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's intense.
Word. But he didn't get that chance and instead became another casualty in this deadly war. But the case is still active and they're both minors, so there ain't too much public info available. With so many deaths on all sides, the beef between the YGs, OGs, and SevSide was really heating up. On August 16th, K-Flock dropped a track, Is You Ready?, where he disses multiple rival rappers, including his own cousin, Dthang. In the first verse, he says, "Boy, ask my ops, it could get ugly. I could do shh like Ice did Sunny." This is referring to the classic film, Paid in Full. In the movie, Mish, one of the main characters played by Mekhi Phifer, has a younger brother who gets kidnapped for ransom. Mish tries to get the money, but he gets killed by Rico, played by Cameron, who steals the drugs to pay Sonny's ransom. Sonny gets killed as a result, and come to find out, he was set up by his own uncle, Ice, who was mad at Mish for kicking him out of the house. So in this bar, K-Flock sends a shot directly to his own cousin, Dthang, and lets him know he's not above setting him up. The song was big in New York, and even got played on Hot 97. So, you can probably guess.
Yeah, we reacted to that too. Go check that out. Is You Ready? K-Flock reaction. Also, go check out our Blovee Neaky reactions. You can run that up. I'm gonna put all the links below. Okay.
The song was big in New York.
It's crazy.
It even got played on Hot 97. So, you can probably guess how the ops felt about this. Dthang quickly hopped on social media and gave his thoughts on the bar, saying, "Can't wait to see Auntie now." A few weeks later, another Rolling 80s member who was affiliated with K-Flock got murdered broad day.
Damn.
The victim was 16-year-old rapper Nas Rolla. He was killed after two men hopped out of a Honda Accord and popped him in the head and chest in SevSide's hood. Police said that Nas Rolla had a long criminal history and got arrested 18 times already, including 10 felonies dating back to May 2017.
10?
How you get arrested 18 times when you're 16? That's crazy.
Yeah. Whew. I don't know.
Did 18 times already, including 10 felonies dating back to May 2017. He was recently arrested for gun possession and was fighting three other open gun cases.
Oh my God, three?
Dthang will hop on
Instagram. Wait, that's crazy. How was he not locked up if he's fighting three?
Because New York City jail system is congested and packed.
Word. And he's a minor.
Yeah, and what happened with New York is that when we got Giuliani in, he was locking everybody up for everything. You smoke weed, you walk with a beer in your hand, you write graffiti, all nonviolent crimes, just locking everybody up. Because the mentality is lock everybody away and throw the key, and all you're doing is creating people coming out even angrier. Worse. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
Don't work.
I remember Glock 9.
So, to answer your question, everything's just packed.
Word.
So, you get locked up, and they're like, "We don't know where to put him. I let him go."
Word. I remember Glock 9 said he got arrested on DJ Vlad like 25 times before he was 18. It's been crazy.
That's nuts.
Possession and was fighting three other open gun cases. Yeah. After his death, Dthang will hop on Instagram and sneak this Nas Rolla, who was his cousin K-Flock's right-hand man, suggesting he might have got set up. Right around the same time Nas Rolla was killed, Dthang dropped Talk Facts, which is pretty much the Bronx version of Who I Smoke, where he disses all his ops, both alive and dead. Mm. On the track, he samples the song Somebody That I Used to Know by Gotye and throws a sub at a different op in almost every bar. Some disses include, "Dougie got shot, but he's still in recovery," sending shots at K-Flock's homie, Dougie B. He also says, "Come on, CJ, you see me when I ain't see you. But you ain't even make a move. So how the f*** when you see me, you gon' shoot." Mm. In this bar, he takes shots at another rival rapper from Portland who did Dthang on the track Kidnap Who, after Dthang said he was gonna kidnap Booba Savage, who's also featured on the track.
Oh yeah, Booba King, like he said, "Kidnap Who, you're gonna end up in the news." We never react to that, but I heard that song.
Never heard that song.
But Booba, Kidnap Booba, he dissed it.
After Dthang said he was gonna kidnap Booba Savage, who's also featured on the track. Later he raps, "Jiggy Man, aka Shot Egg, dumbass got hit. That's word on my mother, they never do shit." Here, he's talking about a rapper named Shot Egg, who's from the OGs and known to go by the name Jiggy Man. So, it looks like Bronx drill is following the same pattern as Chicago and the UK.
Yeah.
Rappers diss each other in songs and follow it up with real violence. What's really crazy is that a lot of them are under 18.
That's a fact. And another thing too, this video should have been longer. There's way more info. He's not in tune to like the NYC drill, because he should have mentioned E-Dot Baby, things from Harlem that are beefing with Bronx dudes too. So he has to come back. He has to come back and do another one.
He probably don't know. I mean, I don't know where he's from, but he did a decent job because he kind of I always hear this one's related to this one, right, or that one, but now he does a good job of explaining it.
No, he does a good job though.
Yeah.
And follow it up with real violence. What's really crazy is that a lot of them are under 18 and still in high school. So really, they don't fully understand the consequences that come with the lifestyle they live in. Hopefully, they pay attention to how hot it's getting in O-Block and they cool it down before it's too late. But with so many lives lost on both sides, it's hard to see an end in sight.
Whoa! It's easy to be bad.
And the crazy shit is the cops don't care.
Oh, that's the video. All right. What are you going to say?
I said, the crazy part is the cops don't care. They be like, they want to kill each other, let them all kill each other.
That's a fact, man. It's Jerry TV. Unless the cops with other people see like this, other documentaries, BX Joe, UK Joe, The War in the Bronx, Hip Hop Daily. Shout out Hip Hop Daily for this job.
You say we play.
Anything you want to say before that in?
You say we play. Whatever you want us to react to, we will react to. Let us know.
That's a fact, man. Shout out to the whole BX, man. It's Jerry TV. VFX Scary Channel. We out of here.